You know, not until I read that book for Dr. James Morrison, how he goes in what causes writers pain. I was really impressed from a medical point of view to understand, wow, if the block is too big, that could be a problem. So when I look at the all over picture, we got a skeleton on the bottom and a skeleton on top. And the horizontal skeleton of the horse tries to move free without interruption. And the human skeleton, okay, they're sitting on the seat bones, on the pelvis. Then you want to be soft in your hips. You want to not pinch with your knees. And you for sure not want to block your ankle. So here you can see, if this would be the kneecap, this is just where this ends. Anything on the kneecap or below the kneecap, you probably had that happen before, where the doctor taps you with a hammer on the knee below or above to see your reflex. And then you say, when your leg goes forward, you say, oh yeah, reflex are still good. So when you ride and your knee hits that, your lower leg is super, super busy. Less is more. So in the dressage saddle, for examples, they hardly had any knee rolls in the late 70s. Now we get more and more and higher blocks. You get the biggest support if the block sits higher. So if you have a young horse or you ride young horses and you need to have something to hold on to, not to fall off, definitely you want to go into a thigh block, which means the support here is not on your knee, it's on your thigh. Think about this old movie, The Man from the Snowy River, right? They had this Australian stock saddle and they have right on top here, right across your biggest muscle right there, right on top, almost like a Western tree where they have these big bars here. You know, you can really get your leg underneath here. It's hard to fall out of that saddle. So if you want a big block, because let's say you ride dressage and that horse has massive movements and you want to have a little bit more support with your leg, I would recommend get the thigh block as high as possible and angle it parallel with your leg, because you can see how this goes parallel. So you don't want to have your block straight. You want that parallel with your thigh. So we call them thigh blocks. If you're a jumper, you would never have anything on your knee. You always have these little rolls in front or in back, and always have your knee free. So the takeaway answer is less is more. If you need a lot of support, get it as high as you can.